Hi children and viewers, in this video I am going to explain how we can find out the refractive index of a prism. So today topic is finding the refractive index of a prism. So this is the important topic, children. So here the same topic is in 10th class and intermediate secondary also, that much of important topic. But in 10th class point of examination point of view, derivation is not much important, but you have to know about the what is angle of prism and what is angle of deviation and how we can find out the refractive index of prism. You have to know about this one. Okay children, here what is prism? First thing is, what is prism? Prism is a transparent material. Here the surfaces of prism should be very transparent. What is mean by transparent? Transparent means which can allow the light through them. So transparent, the medium should be separated by the two plane surfaces of a prism. That is the simply, I will show in our laboratory prism, it is there. I will show clearly that you can understand this one. So children, here just I am drawing the boundaries of prism like this. Simply here it is a triangular shape, will be like this. So this is a one plane surface. For example, I am giving the name A, B, and this is next one. This is in a prism. This is the one, AB is one reflecting surface and refractive surface, and AC is another reflective surface. Here these two plane surfaces are meet at this point, and this is the angle between these two. That should be called generally angle of prism. Angle of prism. The angle between two plane surfaces, that should be called angle of prism. And now children, here BC is the base of the triangle, sorry, base of the prism. So that means the prism is in the shape of a triangle shape, and then what you have to say, the angle between two plane surfaces is called angle of prism. So children, first here you have to understand the what is incident ray and what is emergent ray. So children, first you have to know about what is incident ray, what is emergent ray, and what is refracted ray. You have to know about that. How the light ray will behave when it is incident on a prism? First you have to know about this one. When the light ray is incident on a prism, how it should be acts and how it should be behaves, you have to know about this one. So for that, I am going to draw one diagram for that. The diagram is very important to explain the derivation of a refractive index of prism. First you can understand the diagram, then you can easily derive the derivation. Okay, here I am drawing the diagram in a big size. So here this is the prism. Now here A, B, and C. Got children? So children, here what I told you, AB is one refracted surface and AC is another refracted surface. That's why here one light ray is entered, should be like this. So here now I am saying now PQ. What's that? PQ is the incident ray. Incident ray. Clear? Once it is here, nothing is there. That means what? It is the rarer medium. Nothing but air. This is what? Air. Light is coming from rarer medium, and that should be incident on the one refracted surface. Now it is medium changes, that's why that is going to be refract. So now here QR is what? Here QR is the refracted ray. What's the children? Refracted ray. And what I told you, PQ is the incident ray. Okay, children. Now after that, that is the light is coming right like this. Now RS. So this is the RS. RS is called emergent ray. Emergent ray. Clear? First you have to know about this one. When there is a prism, on that prism on one side the light ray PQ is incident. That's why here PQ is incident ray. And after that here what you have to observe, QR. This QR is the refracted ray. You have to observe the ray first time at this position, QR is refracted because it is coming from relatively denser medium. So here first refraction is takes place at this point Q. Clear? After that the ray is again moving inside the prism. Here QR is the refracted ray. That means what? The light ray is moving through the prism. That's why, that means what you have to say, the ray is moving through the denser medium. After that there should be touches at this point, touches at this point. At this point, or again the light ray is coming from inside prism. What I am telling, this is the denser medium. Prism is the denser medium. PQ is incident ray and QR is refracted ray, and the light is moving through the prism and that should be coming outwards. That's why RS is the emergent ray. In this way, once the light ray is entered or incident on the prism, that is going to be refracted at two points. Clear? Double refraction takes place. Clear? And after that the ray is coming outside. That's why it is called emergent ray. Clear, children? So I think I already explained about the definitions of angle of incidence, angle of refraction and angle of emergence. Okay, again we have to check this here. Now at this point the entire thing is in diagram only, that's why you have to watch carefully. At this point Q, I am going to draw one normal. This is the normal line N1. Children, now this is the PQ is what? Incident ray. PQ is what? Incident ray. And this is the normal line. The angle between normal and incident ray, what we call? Angle of incidence. What we call? Angle of incidence. That's why here I1, I am taking that. What is angle of I? Angle of incidence. Clear, children? And now at this point this is normal and this is what? Refracted ray. What is that? Refracted ray. Now this is R1. The angle between refracted ray and normal, what we call? Angle of refraction. So here R1 is what we call? Angle of refraction. Clear, children? Similarly, at the point R, I am going to draw one more normal line. One more normal line. Clear, children? So here this is what? Normal. This is point here R. Clear? So here this is the normal and this is the emergent ray. What is that? Emergent ray. The angle between normal and emergent ray, what we call? Angle of emergence. What do you call, children? Angle of emergence. So children, here what do you say? Angle of I2 means what? Angle of emergence. Clear? And again, children, this is what? Refracted ray. And this is what? Normal. Here the refraction is going to be like 2 a second time. That's why I am taking that R2. Clear? R1 and R2. So here R1, R2 are the angle of refractions. I1 is angle of emergence and I2 is the angle of refraction. Clear, children? So I1 is angle of incidence. Here this is the N1 is first normal and N2 is the second normal. So due to, with the help of N1 and N2, we can define R1, I1, R2, I2. Clear? A normal between, angle between normal and incident ray, I1, angle of incidence. Normal and refracted ray, R1. Normal and refracted ray, R2. And normal and emergent ray, I2. So angle between these two, these are called what, I2. Okay, so this is about the all angles in that one. Next, children, watch carefully. Now we want to know about the angle of deviation. Angle of deviation, how we can find out the angle of deviation in this diagram? For that, you have to observe clearly. PQ is what? Incident ray. PQ is what? Incident ray. The incident ray is extended forward. Clear? The incident ray is extended forward, and emergent ray is extended backward. Clear, children? So PQ is extended in forward and emergent ray is extended in backward. Now here there is some angle between these two, that is called angle of deviation. What we call angle of deviation? Clear, children? While we are extending the incident ray in forward, extended like this, emergent ray in backward, then there is some angle, that should be what we call angle of deviation. While we are extending the incident ray in forward direction and emergent ray in backward direction, then they will intersect at one point. Where the intersection takes place, then the angle between these two is called angle of deviation. So that should be shown by angle of D. That is what? Angle of deviation. So children, this is about the angle of deviation. Children, don't forget, what is I1? Angle of incidence. And what is I2? Angle of emergence. What is R1? Angle of refraction. And R2? Angle of refraction. And what is D? Angle of deviation. And PQ is incident ray, QR is refracted ray, and RS is the emergent ray. Okay, children. Now here in this diagram, you have to observe few things. Now I am going to explain the derivation. Clear, children? So here the space is not much more, that's why I am going to write very congestedly. That's why you have to watch the video with very attention. Okay, children. Now here ABC, it is the triangle. Clear? Now here AP, here I am taking that is T. AQTR, like this. Here triangle, we are taking some triangle quadrilateral like this, APQT. So this is R and this is Q. Here AQTR, it is the one quadrilateral. What is that? In that, what you have, one quadrilateral is there. In quadrilateral, what you have, some of the angles is 360 degrees. You have to note it. And next thing, we have another triangle. Triangle here QTR. So here we have some triangle QTR, should be like this. This is QTR. And in the same diagram, you have, I am taking this is the U. Now QUR, like this. QUR. QUR. Just the diagrams, what they are inside this main diagram, I am drawing separately. So then we have very clarity about the derivation. AQTR, AQTR, one quadrilateral, and QTR, one triangle, and QUR, another triangle. Okay, children. So we have two triangles and one quadrilateral will be there. After that, children, here you have to notice this one. This is incident ray extended. Clear? And this is a normal. This I am showing the same body here. And this is refracted ray. This is the point here, Q. At this point we have like this, Q. At this point we have like this. This is the normal. And this is what? Angle of incidence. Angle of incidence I1. So children, this I1 here nothing but this is here, same thing. Clear? In geometrical here, this is the I1, that should be equal to the like this, the angle between these two. Because this is the incident ray and this is the normal. Yes. And again, this is the incident ray and this is the normal. Then what you have to say? I1. So here, this is the I1 and this is also I1. Children, watch carefully. This is I1 and this is also I1. Children, already this is the normal and this is the refracted ray. Now this is what? R1. Clear? This is what? R1. And this one what is what? I1. This is what total is? Children, no need to confuse. The total is I1. And in that, this part is what? R1. Then what about this one? Yes, I1 minus R1. What do you have to say? I1 minus R1. Clear? This total is I1. And this also I1. Only this portion. That is what? R1. So then, if it is I1 and this total is I1 and now it is R1 and this one is what? I1 minus R1. Clear, children? Again, I am going to try same thing here. This is the total incident ray and this is the normal. This is what? I1 and this is I1. Clear? Got clarity? According to geometry, I1, I1 both are same. Now here, this is the refracted ray. What is that? Refracted ray. Now this is what? R1. Now this is what here? This total is I1 and this is the R1. Then what right? I1 minus R1. I1 minus R1. Yes. Like that, children, here. Now this is the I1 minus R1 and same thing, this is I2 minus R2. Clear? This is I1 minus R1, this is I2 minus R2. Same thing, children. This is the emergent ray. Emergent ray. And this is what? Normal. What is that? Normal. Now this is what? I2. What is that? I2. And this is also now here I2. I am drawing separately here. This point is same here. This is what? R. At that point, what happening? That is, I am going to explain that. I am trying to do this, explain clearly. So here, this is the point R. This is now I2. And this also I2. And now this is what? Refracted ray. And this is what? R2. Then this means what? I2 minus R2. This is R2. And this is I2 minus R2. Like that. So clear? Simply like this here now. This is U and this is Q and this is R. This triangle. Q, U, R. In that, this is what we call I1 minus R1 and this is I2 minus R2. Clear, children? So now we will go for derivation clearly. Okay, children. First thing is we have to take the quadrilateral. What is that? We have to take the quadrilateral, that is AQTR, AQTR. So here, that means in a quadrilateral, what you have to say? Angle of A plus, angle of Q plus, angle of T plus R is equals to 360 degrees. What do you say? 360 degrees. In a quadrilateral, total angles are? Sum of the angles equals to 360. And in quadrilateral, two angles, opposite angles must be 90-90. That's why here I am writing angle of A plus angle of Q is 90 degrees. and angle of T plus and angle of R also 90, that is 360. Clear? AQTR we are taken. Opposite as on perpendicular angle is 90-90. That's we here. A plus 90 plus 90, 180 plus T is equals to 360. What is that? 360. From that, I am writing A plus T is equals to 360 minus, that will go that side, 180 will go that side. 360 minus 180, 180. That's why here, A plus T is equals to 180. So here I am writing A plus T. A plus T is equals to 180. R, T is equals simply 180 minus A. T is equals to 180 minus A. This is B, equation number 1. Clear? We are taking a quadrilateral, angle of A in a quadrilateral, sum of the angles are 360. Angle of A plus, angle of Q plus, angle of T plus, angle of R is equals to 360. So from that, two angles must be 90-90. That's why here 90 plus 90, 180 degrees. So here A plus 180 plus T is equals to 360. From that, A plus T is equals to 360 minus 180. And A plus T is equals to 180. And this is the T is equals to 180 minus A, equation number 1. And after that, I am taking the another triangle here, QTR. I'm taking QTR. So from triangle, we are taking QTR. In a triangle, what do you know? Sum of the triangle angles should be, what do you say? In a triangle, sum of the angles equals to 180. That's why angle of Q plus, angle of T plus, angle of R is equals to 180. 180. Here, what is angle of Q here? R1. R1 plus angle of T plus and angle of R is R2. In QTR, angle of Q is R1, angle of R is R2, and this is T. So that is equals to 180. Chill, okay. From that, what right? T is equals what right? 180 minus R1 minus R2. Clear? T is equals what right? 180 minus R1 minus minus R2. Then what right here? T is equals to 180 minus minus R1 minus R2. So here, now this is equation number 2. Clear children? We are taking second triangle QTR. From that, angle of Q is R1, angle of R is R2, and angle of T is T. That is equals to 180. That means what? T is equals to 180 minus R1 minus R2. Now we have to compare the equation number 1 and 2. Equation number 1 and 2. In equation number 1, what do you have? T is equals to 180 minus A. And here T is equals to 180 minus R1 minus R2. Now we have to compare the 1 and 2. So from 1 and 2. From 1 and 2. Here what right? 180 minus A is equals to 180 minus of R1 plus R2. Here what do you get? 180, 180 cancel. Minus A is equals to minus of R1 plus R2. Minus minus cancel. What do you get? A is equals to R1 plus R2. So this is another equation number 3. Simply, after equation 1 and 2, we are comparing the 1 and 2. From that, what do you get? A is equals to R1 plus R2. Clear? And next, children, now I am going to take the another triangle here, QUR. QUR. Again, we are taking another triangle, QUR. Again, what you have to say? Angle of Q plus, angle of U plus, and angle of R is equals to 180 degrees. 180 degrees. Clear, children? In any triangle, sum of the angles should be equals to 180. That's why here, in QER also, angle of Q plus, angle of U plus, angle of R is equals to 180. So children, I told you, in QER, what do you say? Angle of Q is I1 minus R1, and angle of R is I2 minus R2. Clear? So Q here means what? I1 minus R1 plus U plus I2 minus R2 is equals to 180. Clear, children? So now we have to know about the angle of U value here. That is, I am drawing here, watch carefully. This is what incident ray extended, and this is what emergent ray extended. Clear, children? This is what D. This is D. Clear, children? Now that is the angle of deviation. Now this is what it is. This angle is 180. That is what? 180. So here this is what U. This point what? U. So children, this total is 180. And this is D angle. And what about this one? Simply 180 minus D. Clear? Again, I am going to explain same thing. Watch carefully. So this is the children incident ray, and this is the emergent ray. What is that? Emergent ray. This point is what? U. The angle between incident ray and emergent ray, what we call angle of deviation. That is what? Angle of deviation D. Angle of deviation D. And children, here watch carefully. This is D, and this is total what it is? Total what it is? 180. 180. Clear? This is what? 180, and this is the D. Then now this is what? 180 minus D. So that's why here, children, U value is nothing but here 180 minus D. 180 minus D. Children, watch carefully. Here I1 minus R1 plus U value is what? 180 minus D. I will get like that. 180, this is what? 180 minus D plus I2 minus R2 is equals to 180. Clear, children? So now 180, 180 cancel. Here I am writing I1 plus I2. I am writing side by side. I1 plus I2 minus R1 minus R2 and minus D is equals to 0. Clear? Then what do you write, children? I1 plus I2, you will write plus R1 plus R2 plus D. Like this, we are bringing the R1, R2 minus D that side. Then what do you get? I1 plus I2 is equals to R1 plus R2 plus D. Already, what is the value of R1 plus R2? A. That's we here. I1 plus I2 is equals to I1 plus I2 is equals to what, right, children? A plus B. This is what? I1 plus, children, very important, children, I1 plus I2 is equals to A plus D. So in this way we derived the number of equations like that. So derivation is not completed up to now. Here just watch it. So here we have I1 plus I2 is equals to A plus D. That is equation number 4. Children, for us some space is required. That's why here I'm going to explain same thing here. Just watch it very fastly, and after that I will erase it. Children, I clearly explained how we can take the I1, R1, I1 minus R1, I2 minus R2, R2, I2, I1. I explained clearly thing. So here, after drawing the diagram very carefully, first we have to take the three. First thing is quadrilateral AQTR. So AQTR we are taken. Here AQ, angle of Q plus, angle of A plus, angle of D plus, angle of R is equals to 360. Any quadrilateral, there are two perpendiculars, 90, 90, there opposite, they are opposite. That's why the total angles are equals to 360, and angle of A means A, and Q means 90, and T means T, and R means 90. 90 plus 90, 180, and A plus T is equals to 360. And after that, here A plus T is equals to, we will get 180. From that, T is equals to 180 minus A, equation number 1. And after that, we are taking the triangle QTR. QTR. Angle of Q means here R1. Angle of T T means T and angle of R means R2. In any triangle, sum of the sides should be equals to 180. So we substitute the values, we will get T is equals to 180 minus R1 minus R2. By comparing these to equation number 1 and 2, we will get A is equals to R1 plus R2. And after that, we are taking the triangle QUR. QUR. Then what you get? Angle of U means 180 minus D. Angle of Q means I1 minus R1. Angle of R means I2 minus R2. So again, so we will get here U is 180 minus D. We will get I1 plus I2 is equals to R1 plus R2 plus D. R1 plus R2 means what? 3. From equation 3, what you have? A. I1 plus I2 is equals to A plus D. Equation number 4. Children, now here we have to remember 3 and equation 4. Very good. That's the important. That's why here I am erasing this one. Okay, children. Here, I hope that this is also not required for us. Okay, children. Here now, already we know that Snell's law. What's that? Mu is equals to sin I by sin R. We know that this is Snell's law. Mu is equals to sin I by sin R. So here, mu is equals to sin I by sin R. I is the angle of incidence and R is the angle of refraction. So by finding the I value, R value, if you can find the I value, R value, and if you can substitute those values in this equation, you will get the refractive index. So I am taking now, this is the equation number 5. So clear, children. And now here, we have some ID curve is there. ID curve. That means we are taking the I value on one axis and D value is another axis. Children, I told you how we can take the I value. For example, if you can take the I value, first thing is 30 degrees. For that, we will go for example, to draw this diagram, you must have some required experimental procedure. That is, here symbol, this is the procedure I am going to tell here. Experimental procedure. First we have to take the prism. And after that, first we have to take the another drawing board. We have to take on the diagram. Look here, children. For example, now this board is the drawing board, and on that we have to fix one paper like this. This is the paper, and that should be fixed with the help of the pin, drawing pins. Now here we have to give the prism and we have to trace the boundaries. We have to trace the boundaries like that. So now can imagine this entire body is now paper. Already we are kept some prism like this, and we are traces the boundaries. And after that we have to draw the one normal. We are drawing some normal here. Clear? After that, by using the protractor, you have to take one line. Clear, children? We have to take the drawing board, and on that we have to give some paper, and again on that what you have to give some prism, and after that we have to trace the boundaries. After that you have to draw, for example, this is A, B, C. On AB side we have to take the one normal line. From by using that normal line, at this point, by using some protractor, we have to select one particular angle. First, I am taking this is the 30 degrees. Clear? And after selecting that 30 degrees line, we have to draw that one. And after that, you have to again keep the prism on that ABC boundaries. Clear? After that, you have to fix the two pins. We have to fix the two pins on that line. So here this is now P and this is Q. Clear, children? No need to confuse. We are taking now here drawing board. On the drawing board, we have to keep some paper. And again, we have to fix the at the four corners at the we have to keep the drawing pins, and now we have to keep the prism in the middle. Again we have to draw the boundaries. After that we are keeping the removing the prism again, and we have to draw the one normal line like this. So after that here we have to take one line that should be here. No, by using the protractor we have to select one particular angle 30 degrees, for that we have to draw the one line. After that again you have to keep the prism exactly, the boundaries must be touches the ABC like that. After that here already two pins we are fixed together. Here we are fixed, this is the P and this is the Q. Now we have to observe the pins from this side. By from this side we have to view the PQ pins from this side. Then children, here this is the projection of P and this is the projection of Q. Clear? Simply after fixing the two pins on the line, we have to observe the those images from the other side AC through the prism at this edge. From this edge, that means here we have to keep our eye at this location. So by keeping our eye, and we have to close another eye, and you have to observe the needles of these two, and then we have to place these some points just in front of the two pins, and again we are drawing one more line. And now again you can remove the prism, and you have to extend this one, and you have to extend this one. Then this is angle of deviation. So simply by keeping some two pins, and you have to find out the traces of the two pins from the other side by our eyes, and you have to keep our eye very close to the prism, and you have to observe the images of PQ in this side. And after that, in front of those pins images, you have to keep the two fixed. For example, this is RS. We have to fix the two other pins RS. So now here simply you can take intersection of the emergent ray, and this is the incident ray. This is what angle of deviation. So I values we got, and 6 DR also we got. Now we have to repeat the same procedure by changing the I values and D values. By changing the I value, we will find out the different D values. First time we have taken 30 degrees. Again, we have to change the another paper sheet. Again, same thing. What is that? We have to take the paper, and this should be kept on a drawing board, and in the middle, what you have to keep some prism. Again, we have to trace the boundaries, and on one side, what you have to take one line, normal line. From that, we have to now, we are for initially, we are taking 30. Now we can go for 35. Again, we are taking some angle 35, and on that line, we have taken 35 degrees of angle. And again, we have to fix the two pins, and now again, keep the prism. And after that, again, from other side, we have to find out the images. So we have to repeat this so many like this. For 30, we have to do 35, 40 like that. So then simply the value should be noted like this: serial number, this is the I value, and this is the D value. For example, just when we are taking I value 30, we will get some 60. And next we are 35 again, 55. Next thing we are taking some 40, we will get some 50. And next we are taking 45, now it is 40. And again, if you can take 50, and this is 60. And if you can take 55, and this is 65 like that. So for every time, the value I we are taken, corresponding that we will find D value. Again, 35, 55, like that. So you can observe the D value. This 40 is the very least value. This 40 is called now here, minimum angle of deviation. Minimum angle of deviation. That means simply here, while we are taking I value increases, what you observe? D value is decreases and reaches the least value, and after that again its value is increases. Initially 60, 55, 50, 40. Again after that what you have to say? It is increases. 60, 65 like that. So that particular 40 value is called least value. That is what we call minimum angle of deviation. Minimum angle of deviation. So just imagine, already we did some experiment in that the value should be like this. So now if you can graph it, if you can plot graph between these two, then we will get the graph should be like this. Graph should be like this. So here, this is the I, and now this is the value. On x-axis what you take I values, on y-axis what you take D values. clear? Now at this point, what I am telling, 40 degrees of angle of deviation. Now this is the least value, minimum angle of deviation. So in this graph, this point is the represents the minimum angle of deviation. Clear? The least value of angle of deviation is called minimum angle of deviation. Clear, children? So now here, at this point, I1 is equals to I2 and R1 is equals to R2. Clear? For minimum angle of deviation, what we take? For minimum angle of deviation, or at minimum angle of deviation, I1 is equals to I2 and R2 is equals to R1. So that's why here, let at minimum angle of deviation, children, no need to confuse, if you can draw or plot graph between angle of incidence and angle of deviation, that should be shown like this. That means angle of deviation value is initially maximum and that should be reaches to the minimum value. Again, after that should be increases. The least value, what we call minimum angle of deviation. At minimum angle of deviation, what you have to say? I1 is equals to I2 is equals to I, and R1 is equals to R2 is equals to R. Now substitute these values in equation number 3 and 4. So here, from equation number 3, what you have? From equation number 3, what right? A is equals to R1 means R and R2 also R, then A is equals to 2R and R is equals to what, right? A by 2. R is equals to A by 2, children. Got this point? At minimum angle of deviation, we have one condition is that I1 is equals to I2 is equals to I and R1 is equals to R2 is equals to R, then R is equals to A by 2. Clear? So what do you get? R is equals to A by 2. Now children, now we go for equation number 4. Equation number 4. That here simply I1 means what? I. And I2 also what? I. And A plus D. A plus D. Here D is the angle of deviation and delta is the minimum angle of deviation. Minimum angle of deviation. Delta. So that's why here what write? I plus I? 2i. 2i is equals to A plus delta. What is that? A plus delta. Here delta means what? That is the angle of deviation, but its value is less. That's why what you have to say? Minimum angle of deviation. Then what right, children? I is equals to A plus delta by 2. I is equals to A plus delta by 2. So children, already we have values now for R and I. Now substitute R value and I value in equation number 5. Then what you get? Mu is equals to sin I. I value is what? A plus delta by 2. Mu is equals to sin of A plus delta by 2 by sin R. R value is what? A by 2. Then sin A by 2. So mu is equals to sin of A plus delta by 2 by sin A by 2. So this is the equation for refractive index of a prism. By substituting the value of A delta in that formula, we will find out the refractive index of prism. Children, very simple. This is the very important here. When we can plot a graph between these two, I and D, we are getting this is the ID curve. When we have considered ID curve for minimum angle of deviation, at minimum angle of deviation, I1 is equals to I2 is equals to I and R1 is equals to R2 is equals to R and delta is equal, D is equals to delta. So already we have, what it is, that equation is there. A is equals to R1 plus R2. Here R1 is R and R2 also R. From that, what it is, A is equals to 2R and R is equals to A by 2. And we have equations that, what it is, that I1 plus I2 is equals to A plus D. Here I1 is I2 also I. That's why I plus I is equals to A plus D. Then delta is equals to what? D is equals to what? Take delta, minimum angle of deviation. Then I plus I is 2i, that is equals to A plus delta, and I is equals to A plus delta by 2, and mu is equals to sin of A plus delta by 2 by sin A by 2. That means simply we substitute I value and R value in this equation number 5, we will get this one. By using this relation, we will find out the refractive index of a prism. Children, I hope you understand. If you can understand this one, like, share, comment the video and subscribe my channel for latest notifications. We will meet in the next video with some other interesting topic. Bye, take care.